What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Mike Dyack. I am a master plumber and HVAC contractor in the states of Florida, South Carolina, and New York. Today, we are in East Meadow, New York, which is a hamlet in the central Nassau County on Long Island area. We have an existing mixed-use customer. Mixed-use because we have a medical office on the first floor, apartment building on the second floor. We got two central AC systems. We're gonna do step-by-step detailed maintenance on how to properly take apart and clean this Rheem Ruud and that Goodman. Are you ready? Let's go. I'm here a little early for this service call to do maintenance on this 3-ton R410A and Goodman. Oh, what we got there? We have a 36. Another 3-ton, and this one is R410A, yep. So these two 3-ton systems, just doing annual maintenance. We haven't been here in a couple years. Let's get rocking and rolling. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is use our right hand with our left hand behind our back. And we're gonna kill power to both units. Now, there's a reason why. That's not going easy. There's a reason why we do it this way, because if there is an electrical short, the voltage will pass through your arm, through the opposite side of your heart of the body, and transfer that current to the ground. So, it's good to be a little cautious. All right, now that the power is removed, we're gonna remove the electrical compartment covers on both units. We're gonna make sure we don't have voltage, and then we're gonna start the disassembly process. All right, I got my voltmeter set to read volts AC. I'm gonna check from L1, L2. I got nothing. And now ground to L1 and ground to L2. Nothing. Okay, let's check the next one the same way and then start pulling the covers off. And by the way, I carefully removed the brown wire from the fan terminal on the dual capacitor, the orange wire from common on the capacitor, and the black wire on L1 of the two-pole contactor. Let's take the panels out. I love the Rheem Ruud units. They are very easy, the newer generation, very easy to disassemble and clean. Now, this unit is not terribly dirty, but removing the covers allows you a good opportunity to really inspect the side closest to the house. Look, she's filthy. Crazy. Both units are disassembled. The side shroud assemblies and the condenser fan motors. I'm gonna grab a bucket and some gloves. We're gonna retrieve all the debris from the inside of both units, dumping all of that debris, vegetation, brush, all that nasty stuff. Let's make them clean, put them into a bucket. Don't dump them on the ground. That's not professional. I'm trying to figure out what all this whiteness is about, but coil looking a little weird there. A little white residue there. I don't know what's up with that. This one, the Goodman, does not have that. Single channel coil, looking pretty good on both. No flaking. Good visual inspection. Just got some dirt, but this white residue, we'll have to document that in our House Call Pro CRM app and make note of that, and we'll monitor this with some pictures at future service calls. All right, I'm using a nylon brush and I'm brushing off all of the dirt and debris from the outdoor coils, brushing it straight down to the bottom, kicking it over a little bit, and then scooping it up and dumping into my bucket. A lot of sand, I'm noticing. And just dust. Spend a little extra time here. It's well worth the reward. Because I did a great job on that one. Kind of. And then we'll give it a good cleaning with the chemical. Alright, I vacuumed out the inside of the base of the cabinet as best I can, as well as the outside perimeter. And then I got my Milwaukee leaf blower and I blew through the coil. I got a lot of dust and dirt out. It's a good step in preconditioning the coil before we start cleaning with the chemical. I did not hit this one up yet. I'm just going to use the leaf blower on this one, but I just want to show you what we're getting out of the coil with the blower. See that? From the coil, and we're not going from the outside in, we're going from the inside out, because that's the direction that air is taking when the condenser fan motor is running. The condenser fan motor is sucking air through the coil from the outside to the inside of it. Maybe I should have got the vacuum, but it was clogged up. So I'll save you. I'll save you some of the aggravation of watching this painstaking video. All right, both outdoor units have been cleaned, pre-treated with the air blower. I also blow out the electrical compartment. We're gonna check the capacitor and the resistance on the coil later on and during the service call. It's now time to get rid of any loose debris. And now we're gonna pre-rinse with some warm water if possible. All right, I hope my water pressure is good. Excellent, this will suffice. All right, so right now I am just pre-rinsing both coils with water. We're gonna saturate the coil, make sure that it's nice and wet throughout. Now, we're lucky because this is a single row coil. When you have them stacked right on top of one another, it makes the job more harder, and sometimes you gotta split them, but be very careful in splitting coils. You break it, you own it. Remember that. So we're gonna pre-rinse both coils, and then we're gonna use the chemical, so stick around. All right, to clean both these coils, since they're not micro-channel coils, I'm gonna use the Nu-Brite by Nu-Calgon. I'm gonna fill this up halfway. This is also the coil gun by Nu-Calgon. I generally get 8 condensers out of a 1 gallon container of Nu-Brite. Okay, so I got a half jug filled of the Nu-Calgon. Now, if she's really, really dirty, I'm gonna put this on setting A. Since she's pretty clean, I'm gonna put it on B. And if we look at our chart, B gives us a ratio of 4 to 1. So 25 ounces per gallon of water. All right, let's go spray it down. All right, we are now washing from the inside out. Okay, remember, move quick. We have 2 coils to do. We're gonna give it a quick coating on the outside. Followed, don't neglect the inside. While the coils are sitting in the chemical, we're gonna rinse out the coil gun. This also gives it an opportunity. The chemical that is, to work its way into all the dirt on the coils. Most importantly, if you don't rinse out your coil gun, tomorrow when you go to use it, she'll be all clogged up. So we're gonna thoroughly rinse out the coil gun, letting the chemical do its due diligence. All right, it's been about 15 minutes. Let's see what the chemical, does. So here's our water going through the coil. She's fairly clean. So we did a great job pre-treating everything and pre-cleaning. Oh, here we go. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, we got some good stuff going there. I don't know if you see it in the camera, but we are definitely making some good progress here. Very, very nice. All right, I am gonna thoroughly rinse both coils. It should take about 10 minutes per coil. You wanna get all the chemical out of here. All right, take your time, there's no rush. We're not going anywhere. We gotta be here for probably 2 hours total for both systems. Now, I've said this a couple times in the past, and I'm gonna say it again. I don't care what other nonsense other YouTubers are talking about when they're talking about, oh, you don't gotta rinse it from the inside out. Just ask yourself this. First, are you stupid or something? But number two, if air is traveling from the outside of the coil, through the coil, and then inside and out, why on earth would you want to wash it from pushing more of that dirt into the coil? Use your freaking common sense, you nincompoops. These YouTubers, I don't even think half of them even licensed. Seriously. And there's one in particular, just, I don't know, likes to just make a mockery of the trades. And it's not a mockery to make fun of. It's a profession. So stay in your lane, I'll stay in mine, but don't give wrong advice. For what? Job security? Are you that insecure at yourself that you have to give false information on how to clean a coil? Come on, it's common sense. When that condenser fan motor is running, it's pulling air through the coil, right? Into the inside and up and out. Why would you force dirt, more dirt back inside the coil? Idiot. All right, when reassembling the Rheem Ruud outdoor condenser units, make sure you put the corners on first, because you won't be able to get the main panels in, because the main panels sit in front of the lip on each corner. All right, before I put the motor back on the top of the condenser, I'm being a good technician and I'm being observant of my surroundings. The sealed fluid inside the motor is no longer there. It's broken out, so I'm making note of the size and specifications of the motor. Also make note of the measurements of the fan blade. Put that on our records so we are good to go in the future should this fan motor fail. Also going to make the customer aware that the condenser fan motor, what happened to it, the condition of it, and make them mindful that this could die in the near future. All right, both units are reassembled, and those who know that the Goodman, there's nothing worse than reassembling the body panels of a Goodman. And God bless you if the ground is wet and you don't have a knee pad. You know what I'm talking about. Those who know. So if you're fortunate enough to have a newer model Rheem or Ruud, or even the older models where the compressor is on a side compartment and they're rectangular in shape, the outdoor unit that is, you know what I'm talking about. But the absolute worst system to disassemble, Goodman, Amana, you know what I'm talking about. This AC unit services the first floor of this mixed-use building. The first floor is a medical office. Upstairs is an apartment. So my priority was getting the first floor medical office back in operation since they opened at 9, and it is 9:30. I've been here since 7:55 in the morning. Good amount of time to thoroughly clean and reassemble two units. So now we're going to check electrical. I'm going to do an underload capacitor test. I'm going to use the HVAC school Vortex Bitex underload capacitor tech capacitor test feature of their app. So the one of the first things we're gonna do is we're gonna take voltage across the capacitor. Sorry, there you go, no glare. And to do that, we're gonna take a voltage of AC reading between common and let's do Herm. So we're gonna do common and Herm. Oh, it's off now. Okay. All right, you know what, let's do it the old fashioned way. All right, I safely discharged the dual capacitor and removed the wiring from common, Herm, and fan. I don't hear anything squishing around in there, so she passed the shake test. The shake test is shaking around. If you hear something squishing around in there, that's not normal. You hear this one shaking around? No, you don't. Okay, my Fluke 902 FC clamp-on meter, by the way, link to purchase this from Amazon in the description box down below. Have it read to read capacitance. I'm going to go from common to Herm. And we have 44.2, so that's good. Common to fan, and we have 5. And since it's a 45 over 5, we are good to go. Let's reassemble this, hook it back up, and then we'll check our resistance of the coil, 24 volt coil on the contactor. All right, I carefully removed the two wires going on the left and right hand side of the contactor. The yellow and the blue wire. Now be very careful, those will carry 24 volts if there's an active coil for cooling, and if you touch metal with one of them, you're gonna blow the fuse and you're gonna have to go to the air handler and replace the fuse. So just be mindful of that. I got my voltmeter set to read resistance, and we're gonna check from one side to the other. Just like that, I'm reading 18.6. Yep, so we are good. Anything in the teens is a good coil resistance on your contactors. All right, I am now at one of the indoor units. One of the first things I did was pull the filter, 20 by 20 by 1, made note of it on the customer's profile, make sure it's noted there. Model, serial number, 2021 model. Take a look at the coil. Let's see how that looks. All right, nothing terrible. I'm gonna remove the access panels and let's check out the blower motor. And we're gonna treat the pan and drain with the Viper and the gel tip by Nu-Calgon. And always remember, ladies and gentlemen, if you ain't testing, you're guessing. And yes, it's trademarked.